Hello, I'm Richard Bryant, Executive Director of the Mary Bell and Sebastian P. Musco Center for the Arts here at Chapman University. Tonight, we're pleased to present a wonderful living room recital in partnership with LA Opera. This unique event is part of our At the Musco online series, where you can connect in real time with our faculty, students, professional artists, and one another, all engaged in what we call the art of community. To learn more about our online events, please visit MuscoCenter.org. LA Opera has been an artistic affiliate and our friend since we opened in spring of 2016. We're especially delighted to welcome tenor Ashley Faatoalia, who is a gifted Chapman University alumnus and off on a great career. Ashley's accompanied by Louise Thomas, Associate Dean of Chapman's College of Performing Arts. To all our alumni out there, welcome to the Homecoming Online Week. I hope to see you all in these seats when it is safe for all of us to come back. And in the meantime, now, please enjoy this special living room recital.
Hey everyone, my name is Ashley Faatoalia, and thank you so much for being here this afternoon for our recital. On behalf of Los Angeles Opera, the Musco Center and College of Performing Arts at Chapman University, we're just super excited to present our recital this afternoon. I'm joined by my mentor and friend, Dr. Louise Thomas, and I'm gonna ask her to step forward just for a moment so you can hear a little bit from her.
Hi, everybody. Just delighted to be participating in this Los Angeles Opera's At Home series. It gives me great pleasure to perform in person once again, and also to be presenting this recital with one of our most treasured alumni, Ashley Faatoalia. He makes us proud every day. So I'm really thrilled to be here, and I hope that you enjoy the recital. So thank you, Ash. Shall we do it?
Let's do it.
Das andere heißet nein. Die beiden Brötchen schließen die ganze Welt mir ein. Merchants listen, die ganze Welt mir ein. O Pöschlein meiner Liebe, was bist du wunderlich?
Was from Schubert's song cycle, Die Schöne Müllerin, and I am really taking a moment to reflect and to memorialize some of my time at Chapman, and this set of art songs that I'm doing were all songs that I recall well from my time with my voice teacher and friend, Dr. Peter Atherton. And we still keep in touch, but he was my teacher at Chapman, and we worked diligently on these art songs. And they were sort of my foundation, some of my first entrances into the world of classical singing through these songs and translating them and learning all of the different nuances and interpretations, studying again with Dr. Thomas and collaborative arts and doing other things with the poetry and learning the text. So these bring back great fond memories for me. The next selection is another one of those songs, and this is the setting of Orpheus with His Lute by Ray Vaughan Williams.
Orpheus with his lute made trees and the mountain tops that freeze bow themselves when he did sing to his music plants and flowers. Oh,
Because it's fall, because it's, yes, autumn, I felt it would be appropriate to do this one. Call me hoaxy, call me corny if you want, but I felt like it fit. Autumn of the misty skies of regrets, that's the poetic translation, but basically, regret and fall. That's my joke of the French poem, Autumn.
Ciel brumé aux horizons navrants. Au rapide couchant aux aurores pâlies, je regarde
songs by two settings of by different composers, the same poet, our dear brother Langston Hughes, and two of his wonderful works, one Dream Variation and one Harlem Night Song by Margaret Bonds and Ricky Ian Gordon, respectively.
Wide in some place in the sun, to whirl and to dance till the white day is done. stream. While night comes on gently, dark like me, that is my dream. To fling my arms wide in the face of the sun, dance, whirl, whirl, till the quick day is done.
Enjoy that. I have fun doing it, don't you, Louise?
Yeah, indeed.
Too much fun over here. It's that is the joy of bringing different composers to someone's text, and it's really beautiful to hear two different ideas of the same poet, and really two different shades of color that both the poet and the composers are painting with. I just love those words, and I think that even more now, it's important to promote that work and to just continue shedding light on the works of many of our African-American brothers and sisters who've gone on before, those who are currently working and doing the work. I just celebrate us all, and I know that LA Opera and Chapman are both institutions that celebrate our diversity as well. So I just wanted to add those in, and I thank you, and I hope you enjoyed them. So now it's actually time for a little show and tell, so pardon me, I'm gonna hop off camera for just a second and grab something, a visual aid, if you will. So I have with me several DVDs from my time at Chapman University. So first of all, I would just like to give a wonderful shout out, of course, again to Dr. Peter Atherton and Opera Chapman at Chapman University. And the next selection is actually from the last production I got to do with Opera Chapman. I got to perform as Tamino. I'm gonna bring this up close so you guys can see it. This is the actual DVD. Let me get out of the camera so you can see it. Focus, yes, there it is. There we are, the Magic Flute, Chapman University. I'm gonna tell you the year because I was class of 2006. So this was just a few years ago now. But it was a wonderful time, and all of the experiences that we had together at Opera Chapman are ones that I still carry with me onto the professional stage. A lot of the things that I learned from Dr. Atherton, from all of my colleagues and friends in the program, you bring with you, you bring all that experience. And I actually was fortunate after college to go with Dr. Atherton to Rome and do this role in Opera Festival di Roma, which was a production, a program that Peter was a part of, and it was a wonderful festival and a wonderful memory of my first time getting to do this with a professional, semi-professional orchestra. So this is Tamino's aria from Mozart's Die Zauberflöte.
Dies Bildnis ist bezaubernd schön, wie noch kein Auge je gesehen. Ich fühl es, wie dies Götterbild mein
Sure. Tamino runs off to find his love, Pamina, as instructed by the Queen of the Night. But of course he goes into the temple and he finds out things aren't exactly as he seems. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to opera. Things are never exactly as they seem, and there's always more to the plot. Another wonderful experience I've had since Chapman, directly really following Chapman, I had the pleasure of auditioning for Porgy and Bess at LA Opera. It ended up being my debut performance with the company, and it's a special memory for me. I remember walking into the Dorothy Chandler Pavilion and walking out onto the stage for the first time and sending a text message to my mom saying, I really can't believe I'm on the stage where you took me when I was a kid. I don't want to get emotional, but I remember this. She used to take me when my uncle was out of town. He had season tickets to LA Phil when they played at Dorothy Chandler. And so I would go with her to Upbeat Live into the concerts. And so it was surreal for me remembering seeing that and then being on the stage, a very proud moment for me. So Porgy and Bess has become, of course, something that I've been fortunate enough to do at different companies around the country. And this particular aria by the character Sport and Life, if you know anything about the story, it actually is Sport and Life. It's his behavior in this aria that actually splits Porgy and Bess up. And Bess ends up going back to her old ways after Sport and Life offers this plea to her.
There's a boat that's leaving soon for New York. Come with me. That's where we belong, sister. You and me can live that high life in New York. Come with me. There you can't go wrong, sister. I'll dress you the swellest mansion up on Upper Fifth Avenue. And through Harlem we'll go strutting, we'll go a strutting, and there'll be nothing too good for you. I'll dress you in silks and satins, in the latest Paris styles, and all the blues you'll be forgetting, you'll be forgetting. There'll be no fretting, just nothing but smiles. Come along with me, that's the place. Don't be a fool.
Not exactly reluctantly, for poor Porgy's shock and dismay when he returns. The great, amazing work, truly the first American contribution to the canon of opera, Gershwin's great Porgy and Bess, all the reverence and all of the admiration for that work. Next is a selection from Puccini's Girl of the Golden West, and I chose it seems kind of strange for my Fach and everything that I do, but I actually chose it because it has double meaning. I'm fortunate to work with LA Opera Connects. We are the community and engagement department branch of LA Opera, but more than that, truly we connect with the community. And under the direction of our Vice President, Dr. Stacey Brightman, and Associate Director Jennifer Babcock, we are just super about the mission of spreading opera in all places, because we believe opera is for all people. And so one of the productions we do is called The Prospector, and it's a lot of fun, and I get to be a coyote when I do it, and get to goof around, but every now and then you get to sing Johnson's aria, and it's just a beautiful piece, and it's one that I love. But it has double meaning for me as a Chapman student, as an alumni of the program. I studied and had the fortune of being mentored by the great Carol Neblett, who we just recently lost. She was a faculty member and friend, and truly just an artist of the world and a spirit that everyone knew and loved in the business, and a guiding force for a lot of us Chapman students and kids. And she was famous for the role of Minnie and is known on the recordings. And so I just want to dedicate this to the memory of our dear late Carol Neblett.
Quella mi crea libere lontano sopra la nuova via di redenzione aspetterà che io torni passeranno i giorni, e passeranno i giorni, e io.
Set that is very dear to me. Of course, all this music holds special meaning and memory. I began doing spirituals really my senior year at Chapman. I remember Dr. Atherton telling me and connecting me with Dr. Daryl Taylor at UC Irvine, who many of you know as a great source and a champion for African American art song. And so learning a little bit about the rep at the time, but since then I have just been fortunate to work with colleagues who have turned me on to different music and different arrangements. So these are two of my favorite, two that we know very much. They now show up almost as standard lit, and I just love that. I think that we should have more of that. So two spirituals, one by, well, I won't give them away. They're on the set list, so here they are.
King Jesus, no man can hinder me. Ride on, King Jesus, ride on, no man can hinder me. For he is King of kings, he is Lord of lords. Jesus Christ, the first and last, no man works like him. For he is King of kings, he is Lord of lords. Jesus Christ, the first and last, no man works like him. King Jesus rides a milk-white horse, no man works like him. The river of Jordan, he did frost, no man works like him. For he is King of kings, Lord of lords. Jesus Christ, the first and last, oh. King Jesus ride in the middle of the air, oh, he calls the saints from everywhere. Oh, ride on, King Jesus. No man can hinder me. Ride on, King Jesus. Ride on, no man can hinder me. He is the King, he is the Lord, oh. He is the King, he is the Lord, oh, Jesus Christ, the first and last. No man works like him. Ride on, ride on, ride on, ride on, Jesus. The whole world in his hand, he's got the whole world in his hand, he's got the whole world in his hand, he's got the whole world in his hand. The woods and the waters in his hand, he's got the woods and the waters in his hand, he's got the sun and the moon right in his hand, he's got the whole world in his hand. The birds and the bees right in his hand. He's got the birds and the bees right in his hand. He's got the beasts of the field right in his hand. He's got the whole world in his hand.
I just love those two. Hal Johnson and Margaret Bonds were the two composers, of course. Pardon me. But I'm actually going to ask Louise, maybe just a little reprise of that from the beginning. I'm going to do a little costume change for our finale. Would you please?
Thank you.
had to. Come on. I had to. Are you kidding me? Chapman. Go Panthers. Okay, so for our finale, I wanted to do something also with significance and meaning, something special to me. When I finished at Chapman, I had mentors and teachers and friends who wanted to make sure I didn't starve, who wanted to make sure I actually was doing well. And one such mentor and friend was Dr. Thomas, whose husband was kind enough to say, "Hey, Ash, I have some recording gigs. Maybe you could use the work. Maybe we could work together." We ended up hitting it off. And from that relationship, I decided to do a CD, an album of jazz standards. And when I needed someone to produce it, I asked Louise's husband, John. And truly, they've become dear family friends of mine and my family. And this song, I think, just has wonderful meaning for any time in the world, but particularly right now. It's one that John and I recorded for that album. And Louise will remember that fondly, being in the studio with us and checking, picking keys and all of that. But this song just says everything else that I can't say right now. I'm just so grateful to have been a part of the LA Opera at Home series and homecoming week at Chapman University. Go Panthers. And this is Smile by Charlie Chaplin.
Even though it's breaking, when there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by if you smile through your fear and sorrow. Smile and maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through for you. Light up your face with gladness, hide every trace of sadness, although a tear maybe ever so near, that's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll see that life is still worthwhile if you just still worthwhile if you just smile.
Thank you so much. You guys have been a pleasure. I am just so grateful to have been able to present this program with you this afternoon and with my friend and mentor, Dr. Louise Thomas. I'm gonna put my mask back on so we can take a bow together. How about that? I think we can all agree. Dr. Thomas, thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Ashley.
Oh, it's so nice to be able to collaborate in some, the best way we can right now. So we are just really grateful, and go Panthers.
Go Panthers.
Bye, guys.
Bye, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you.